position?
We know your position, John. I have an exact fix on your coordinates, ready to jaunt you back at a moment's notice.
No, Jim, there are other saps trapped down here as well as Jim. We've got to try and save them.
Let me jump down and help.
No, Kenny, I've got no time to argue. Talk to him, Tim.
Tim, jaunt me down.
No, Kenny, I must insist you stay here with me.
I can't do anything if you're all tramping over one another and getting hysterical. So calm down and shut up. Our only chance is to find the person who started all this. And that person is the Spidron. Now, come on, search for anything. Anything at all that looks as though it would lead us to a control center. Now, come on.
What a pity we can't stay a little longer to enjoy the fun. However, there's no sense in taking unnecessary risks.
What are you going to do?
I already have, my dear. Goodbye. You know how to contact me, Sandor.
Oh, no, you don't, darling. It's one trip you ain't going to take.
Spidron!
Ah!
This way's blocked as well.
Let's try this way. Come on, everybody!
Oversized mousetrap. Oh, thanks, John. Oh, that's better. Oh. Flattened by a flaming bird. I'll never live it down.
Which of the lava flow controls, you know?
Don't worry about it, mate. I'll turn them off, both of them.
Good man.
Oh, fencing up the back rider pictures of that one, eh? Oh.
See, is this some sort of jaunting cubicle?
No, it's a matter transmitter. Primitive, but it could have taken Sander to any point on your planet's surface.
Oh, could we use it to help save the saps and get them back to the surface?
Be careful. Maybe booby-trapped. That would be just like Sander and the Spidron. It could disintegrate the first person to enter it.
But how can we make sure it's safe?
Only by one of us entering it to see.
Right. Hey.
No, Stephen!
Well, someone has to.
Yeah, but who?
Well, here goes,
Stephen!
It seems to be safe.
Now we can start to send the saps, as you call them, back to where they belong.
But what about Sander?
Could be anywhere. It isn't really where she is that bothers me. It's where the Spidron's got.
You're a fool, Steen! And I've never been able to suffer fools gladly.
Just stay right where you are, Spidron.
You think I would allow myself to be trapped down here like some sewer rat? I'm not the one who's trapped, Steen. You are trapped on this doomed little planet by the most potent bonds of all, by your own sense of duty. Because you know and I know that you will never leave until you've either arrested me or driven me off. And you aren't going to find me, Steen. Not in time.
Not in time for what?
I need to enjoy watching you die, Steen. You and your telepathic friends and all the rest of the miserable aboriginals on this primitive backwater. I'm going to enjoy it, Steen. Enjoy it.
He's using another mass transmitter.
No.
Then he jaunted.
No, he didn't. He can't.
But we saw him do it.
You saw him vanish. That isn't the same thing. The Spidron is incapable of jaunting, as you call it, just as he's incapable of telepathy or teleportation. That's why he's so psychotic about people like ourselves who can do those things. It's the basis of his criminal drive. That's why if I could ever get him back to Federation headquarters and treated for it, the galaxy would be rid of its biggest headache.
But if he didn't jaunt, what other explanation is there?
There you are.
Oh, yeah? What's that thing, then?
A holograph projector.
Oh, what's that when it's at home?
Well, it's like a film projector, Ginge. Only it projects a three-dimensional image.
What, you mean it looked like he was there, but he wasn't? It was like a movie film?
That's right.
Hey, crafty, eh?
Yes, he's always been that.
Well, what do we do now?
We have to use the matter transmitter to get all those poor, unfortunate people back where they belong. Then I'd like to use your computer to go through all the available material, just in case there's a clue to the whereabouts of Spydron.
On the east coast of England. The San Andreas fault has slipped three times in 24 hours. The authorities say that plans are already well advanced for the area's complete evacuation. All trace has been lost to four trawlers, last reported to be fighting a losing battle against appalling conditions in the North Atlantic. One of the skippers reported the weather as the worst he has ever encountered. Planes are being diverted from Heathrow since a crack appeared in the main runway.
All right, Tim, that's enough. Thanks.
Only there was some sort of definite pattern.
A pattern isn't going to provide the answer to our problem this time. We've simply got to find where the Spydron's control point is. That's the third in 24 hours.
Getting more frequent.
Steam, the Federation, the Galactic Federation, perhaps they could do something.
What do you suggest?
Well, couldn't they import some magnolite to replace what's been taken?
Where would they get it from? If magnolite wasn't so rare, it wouldn't be so valuable. And Spydron and Sander wouldn't be going to all this trouble to get hold of it.
Well, is there no synthetic substance that'll do the same job?
Scientists have been trying to find one for thousands of Earth years.
There must be something. I can't believe the Federation would just leave a planet with millions of inhabitants to die.
They have done before. They've had to.
Well, couldn't they organize an airlift or something? Evacuate the Earth? I mean, there must be other planets where man could live in.
There are, but can you imagine the difficulties? The saps can't jaunt. We'd have to use spaceships or matter transmitters.
Well?
Even with spaceships able to carry 30,000 people. And they do exist. Assuming enough of them could be got here on time, and assuming the saps would cooperate and the whole operation went off smoothly, Tim, compute what that would mean.
Just to give you some idea of the scale of the operation, Stephen, if one spaceship carrying 30,000 people could be loaded and launched every minute, that would just keep pace with the rate of increase in the world's population. To evacuate the Earth would need such a spaceship.
And they're almost as large as your moon.
Such a spaceship leaving every second.
And the Earth would still disintegrate before the operation was half finished.
It's just not possible, is it?
Well, perhaps they could send some more galactic police.
Yes, they could. But at the last count, there were 64 million planets in the Federation spread across five galaxies. And 1 million plus, including the Earth, soon to become eligible for admission. I'm afraid your Earth is a very small piece of rock revolving round a very insignificant sun on the rim of a rather unimportant galaxy. You're lucky to have me, and I'm all they'll send. If I start to ask for reinforcements, they might just order me away.
I think we get the picture. It means we're on our own.
Yes. All right, let's go through it all again, shall we? The first indication of a change in the seismic pattern happened 4 years ago, right?
Right.
So they've been at work ever since. I think it's fairly safe to assume so. That doesn't give us much time.
Hardly our fault, I'm afraid. We really should have noticed their presence earlier.
They're good at concealing their presence. Question is, where are they hiding now? Where on Earth, if they are?
Joy. She's a shapeshifter.
No, she's a humanoid. You see her in her natural shape. She can't alter it.
Well, that's something.
So if we could find the girl, that might be a start.
Captain. Rather bites me at home.
How long are we going to stay here, Spy John? We've got all the magnemite we need. Why don't we go now?
You know why.
You're playing a very dangerous game, Spy John.
I want to be sure I haven't missed him. It's wearying knowing that we're being torn in the galaxy. There he is, like an avenging shadow.
Didn't used to bother you?
He's an irritation, a running sore at my side. I will deal with him once and for all.
That's exactly what he's planning to do with you. Probably at this very moment.
How does the Spydron travel? Between planets, I mean.
By Kalinar.
Kalinar? What's that?
What you'd call a UFO, flying saucer. Standard equipment for non-jaunting species such as Spydron.
Tim, I want a complete rundown of all UFO sightings for the period we're concerned with.
Check.
Let's start near home. Were any of them seen over London?
Only one.
When was that recorded?
Approximately 12 months before the start of the period you're concerned with.
And was that the only one?
According to my records, yes. But the sighting is unconfirmed. I have only local newspaper reports.
I'm sure it's the cutting.
At least two eyewitnesses are able to swear that last night they saw a flying saucer hovering over Kingston on the River Thames. They say the saucer dipped and plunged into the water some 2 miles upriver from the lock at Teddington.
That would certainly fit the pattern. What better place to hide a Kalinar than in the mud at the bottom of a river?
Just a beast of flaming burn, that's me. Oh, what it, stupid! It's that in the boat, not me in the drink. What do you got in there, then? Bullion from the Bank of England?
Will this really detect the Spydron?
It is there.
Which end of the boat do you want us in, then?
Sorry, there's not enough room for you all.
You said we could come with you.
Yes, but I had to, hadn't I?
How's that then?
Well, if I hadn't, you wouldn't have hugged the stuff down the steps for us, would you?
Oh, sound joke. Listen, you want to get back up there, mate? Handing out parking tickets on the Milky Way.
Spydron. It's Steam. He's here with a boat.
Arrest him! It's time something was done to put an end to his interference.
He's got company. Those TPs and their two friends.
How very interesting. I leave you to look after them. I'll deal with Steam in my own way.
Another pass, John.
There's something down there.
Do you think it's the Kalinar?
Yes, it's possible.
Does that mean the Spydron's down there now?
Well, no, I don't think it's likely.
Why?
Because the bed of a river may be a convenient place to park, but it isn't a very convenient base from which to operate. I'd say if his ship is down there, Spydron's somewhere nearby, but on shore.
Presumably underground.
Yes.
Goodbye, Steam. It's been nice, Daniel.
Hi, John. It's one of the jaunt. Jaunt your life.
Otherwise, he would never have broken cover.
Where's Ginger and Lefty?
Perhaps they went back. But they wouldn't leave their bikes.
Look, Steen, over there. It's a sewer entrance.
Come on.
Ah!
I didn't need the headlights down here.
They don't usually. The spider must have put them specially in.
I don't like this.
What do you mean?
It's just a feeling.
Better expect trouble, Steen. We've all come to trust Carol's intuition. It's one of her gifts.
Come on.
We have found the spider.
What?
We will lead you to him. We will lead
you. Look out!
What happened? Listen, what you going to have to do that for?
You'll be all right now. The spider probably didn't have time to put you under full control.
Ginge, what happened?
Well, I don't know, darling. One of you is staying on the embankment, mind their own business.
Come on.
For both of us.
Exactly what I say, my dear. I've enjoyed our little partnership, and if I could get you out of here, I would, but I can't. The only access point for a member of your species is already blocked.
The matter transmitter. I used it only this morning to stow that magnemite.
Alas, it is malfunctioning. Should you try to use it, your essence would probably be spread halfway across the galaxy.
You've deliberately sabotaged the transmitter to cheat me out of my half of the magnemite.
I'm afraid I did, my dear. I've always suffered from it. Psychotic greed.
You rat!
Goodbye, Sandor. Goodbye.
Where's the Spider? Where is he? I said, where is he?
He's there. It's one of his characteristics to rearrange the molecular structure of his body cells, turn himself into a liquid, and simply flow away.
But he's taken the magnemite with him.
That's just it.
Won't you share the joke with us?
Yes. No. No, why should I? All right, Steen. You've got me. Now arrest me. Put the mind bind on me and take me away for trial. I can't stand this stinking little planet any longer.
You'd like that, wouldn't you, Sander? Me to arrest you and get you off the surface of this planet before it breaks up. I'm not so sure that I will.
You've got to. You can't leave me here. I've a right to a fair trial.
And the rest of the people on this planet don't have. Don't even have the right to survive. Is that it, Sander? What would you get if I take you back?
Oh, I don't know, a little corrective therapy and they'll turn me into a good girl, I suppose. But I bet I'll be free long before you've even finished filing your reports.
This is as good a place to wait as any. Sandor and I will wait here. Honestly, there's nothing you're not going to do anymore. I suggest you say your goodbyes and jaunt to Sophostria. The Sophostrians are your friends. They'll take you in.
No, listen, he's right. Just because we're stuck here, there's no need for you to be. Look, don't worry about me, lady here. Lefty and me will look her after and make sure she gets what's coming to her.
It doesn't seem right. It's not right, and we're not going. At least I'm not. Nor me. Me neither.
John, you must at least get them all out of here.
Look, come on, there's no point. I can go here. Let's get out of here, please. Go on.
But neither, Steve!
Come on, John.
Steve! You've got to take me off this planet. I demand my rights.
You're the soul's world, Dando. I've got no power to make an arrest. You're free to go.
I can't get off this planet by myself. You know that, Steve.
Then stay and enjoy your freedom while it lasts.
Very well.
How did you know, Steve?
I didn't, not for sure. But I couldn't help wondering what she was laughing at. I just acted on a hunch, that's all.
Intuition.
That's right, intuition and professional judgment. I knew that Sander had worked with the spy drone before. She knew he wasn't to be trusted, but then neither was she, for that matter. It was a fair bet they tried to double-cross each other.
Nice people.
I give half my pension to see Spydron's face when he finds that he's hightailing it out of this sector of the galaxy with nothing more valuable than a hole full of mercury.
But how did you re-inject the magmanite back into the Earth's crust?
While Sander was substituting it for mercury, she stored the magmanite into containers at each of the mining areas. As you remember, magmanite is a chemical. As the lava reached the containers, they exploded. The magmanite escaped and seeped back into the Earth's crust.
Bit of a long shot, wasn't it? Banking on the magmanite still being on the Earth.
It may have been a long shot, but it's the only shot we got left. I was certain Sander wouldn't choose to die if there was any chance of saving herself.
She sounds a dangerous lady.
She is.
Won't you get into trouble when you get back, when they find out that you had her in your hands and then you just let her go?
Probably. But it was a fair enough deal. She did actually tell me where she'd hidden the magmanite, and once I knew that, I knew the world was safe. It's a fair swap. The life of a newly opened planet in exchange for the freedom of one petty criminal.
Well, if smashing up planets is a petty crime in your book, Steen, I hate to think what you call a serious one.
So do I sometimes.
I bet there'll be some fireworks when Sander and Spydron meet up with each other again.
Yes, that's what I'm hoping will happen. Since I managed to plant a microbug on her, I shall always know where she is. So if she does meet up with a Spydron again, I can get them both.
Well, what happens to the Earth now? If it's no longer a closed planet, are we to expect visitors from outer space?
Oh, no. Non-telepathic races will come anyway from time to time, because they don't know about closed worlds. But telepaths will only come with your permission. You and others.
Others? Well, I thought we were the only ones.
Well, you are so far, but there'll be others, won't there? If your species follows the normal pattern, most of the children alive today are potential telepaths. All they have to do is find the key within themselves. That unlocks the special powers we telepaths possess.
Yes, it'll be good when there's more of us.
More of you lot? I mean, we could stand here, could we, Lefty?
Hello, Ginge.